Now, he used to be the lead singer for Black Flag, but he's like the epitome of lead singer rock and roll. He doesn't even need an audience. All he needs to do is a microphone and some loud volume. This is my man. I learned a lot from Henry Rollins. For those of y'all don't know,
you know what you like, I know what I like. So why don't you just be honest and do what you want on stage, and I'll take it or leave it for what it is.
Hello. My name is Henry. I've been thinking about you. I met Henry Rollins in a little cafe on the Lower East Side. I probably wouldn't have met him were it not for the fact that he has a publishing company. And I had a book. I have a book called I Need More. I wanted to republish this year. He had offered to do so, so I wanted to check him out and see what kind of guy he was. I liked him a lot, and one thing led to another, and I started going to his gigs, enjoyed the gigs, and ended up singing on a gig with him, and he came over. I sort of nudged him, grabbed him by the t-shirt, come on, you know, just take an hour between your sound check and your show and come over to the studio and sort of join in with me. So he did. I went off an Australian tour and came back. When it was time to re-record, I thought the way to kick off the session was to start with Louie Louie, because it's a friendly song, and I didn't want my band and I to have to go in and think, okay, the pressure's on, this is it, hit or die. So it was a nice way to loosen everything up, and plus which, hey, Louie Louie's a hit, right? Ambition, to make better music, live life in peace, and then die. Not so easy to do. When I got a chance to have a band of my own, which the first one I had was the Stooges, it was paramount to maintain a certain level of attention. There's a certain energy that it takes to go all the way and really be inside the thing when you're doing it, and do it all the way and express yourself. Yeah. There's a lot in my particular personal human condition that's hard for me to take. I'm sensitive. If you hassle me or wrong me in daily life, I'll tend to just hold it inside. I won't do anything about it. And I found an outlet through the music. And I also found a courage through the music to take chances that I probably wouldn't have had the courage to do in life had I not had that device. And I feel very lucky. Was to start with Louie Louie, because it's a friendly song. And I didn't want my band and I to have to go in and think, okay, the pressure's on, this is it, hit or die. So it was a nice way to loosen everything up, and plus which, hey, Louie Louie's a hit, right? Whoa, baby. I really gotta go now. Ambition, to make better music, live life in peace, and then die. Not so easy to do. Life again. When I got a chance to have a band of my own, which the first one I had was the Stooges, it was paramount to maintain a certain level of attention. There's a certain energy that it takes to go all the way and really be inside the thing when you're doing it, and do it all the way and express yourself. Yeah. There's a lot in my particular personal human condition that's hard for me to take. I'm sensitive. If you hassle me or wrong me in daily life, I'll tend to just hold it inside. I won't do anything about it. And I found an outlet through the music. And I also found a courage through the music to take chances that I probably wouldn't have had the courage to do in life had I not had that device. And I feel very lucky. I don't think you have to be a musician to do that. I think you could do it as an elevator operator somehow. But, you know, that's the way it's gone for me. It's been through the music. Check out my record, because it's really good. And when I play around your town, come and check that out too, because it'll be the same, only more. See you later.
Mentioned to me, I didn't even think of